Okay, so 4-1 is there. So 4-1 representation of here 4-1 is equivalent to 7 bits actually. Yes, this is total 7 bits. So first 4 is represented by 3 bits. First 4 is represented by 3 bits and the next one is represented by 4 bits. So total 7 bits are isme. Okay, jo pehle wala hai, it is represented by 3 bits and then the next number is represented by 4 bits. So 4 ke liye, what is the number? Number is 4 ke liye 111, then 1 is represented as 0001. So the alphabetical A is represented as 111, is represented as 41, that is 31 for this 4 and then next one is 001. Then if you see the number, so 39 is the code. The 39 is the code for 9. So how to represent this 39 you will see. So I told you already 3 is represented by 3 bits, the 9 is represented by 4 bits. Okay, so 3 is represented as 011 is the 3, then 9 is represented as 1001. Okay, so this is the code. So if you want to transmit 9, you have to use this code. So if you want to transmit the alphabetic A, then you have to use this code. Okay, then after that, if you take any 30 or 31 is the code for 1. So 3 as it is 011 and 1 is 0001. So 7 bits means first bit is for 3 bits. First bit is represented as a 3 bit and the second bit is represented as 4 bits. Okay. So ASCII code is very very important as far as personal computer is concerned. So personal computer is the most widely, even nowadays also, for the data communication purpose, wherever we see in the different applications, commercial applications of banking system, air reservation system or train reservation system, wherever we see, we use this ASCII code only for communication purpose, for data communication. In order to communicate the data from one place to another place, we use this ASCII code, and as well as it is a most widely used code for personal computers. Okay, ASCII code applications you can see here in the slide. It is used for the communication applications and is widely used in personal computers as the prime character code. So ASCII code stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Okay, it is a 7 bit code. Each code is represented by 7 bits. Then after that, how many codes, how many symbols are available, how many different codes are available? There are 128. So how we got that 128? 2 to the power of 7 is equivalent to 128, and then all the 128 codes have been defined. Okay, no vacancies here. All the codes have been defined. So it is a perfect code for personal computer and for the data communication applications. So next code is EBCDIC. It is also an example for alphanumeric code. Okay, be clear with the concept. Alphanumeric means the code which consists of alphabetical and numbers. Okay, so EBCDIC. So EBCDIC stands for extended binary coded decimal interchange code. Okay, so these are all developed by EBCDIC code is developed by IBM, International Business Machines Corporation, for use with its mainframe computers and peripheral equipment. Okay, for IBM, International Business Corporation has developed this EBCDIC code. Okay, this is called extended binary coded decimal interchange code. So here, this is also an alphanumeric code. So each code is represented. There are codes which can have different numbers as well as alphabetical. Okay. So this is a 8-bit code. This is a 8-bit code. So each code is represented by 8 different bits. That is the meaning of that. Okay. So here in this alphanumeric code, second one is EBCDIC. Extended binary coded decimal interchange code. Okay, so EBCDIC code, extended binary coded decimal interchange code. Okay, this code is was developed by IBM. IBM. Okay, so now here each code is represented by 8 bits. Okay, so each code is represented by 8 bits here. Whatever we have seen, the ASCII code, ASCII code also we have seen. There each code is represented by 7 bits, but here each code is represented by 8 bits. So 2 to the power of 8 is equivalent to 256 codes. There must be 256 codes. Out of these 256 codes, there are only 139 codes are defined. Only 139 codes are defined here. Not like ASCII code. ASCII code, all the codes, all the 128 codes have been defined. But here, out of 256, only 139 codes have been defined. Remaining codes are not defined. Like remaining 117 codes are not defined. So this is the main drawback of this particular code, EBCDIC. Okay, so in that ASCII code, all the codes have been defined. Okay, and here only out of 256, only 139 codes are being defined, but remaining 117 are not being defined. But the main advantage is there. The advantage is there may be possibility of doing research of inventing new codes. That is the advantage. And disadvantage is user find difficulty when because there are many vacancies in this particular code. So when you have few codes are there which are not defined. So user find difficulty in using this code. Okay. So advantage is there, disadvantage is there. But whereas ASCII code, all the codes have been defined. So there is no possibility of inventing new code over there. But here there is a possibility of inventing new code. So those new invented codes can be fit into the vacant positions. So that is the main advantage and disadvantage of this particular this alphanumeric code. Okay. Next, if you see the example for alphabet A. A is so how to write the EBCDIC code for alphabet A. So for alphabet lowercase letter A, the code is 81. Code is 81. So you have to problem in here. Why? Because it is a 8-bit code. So 2 bits are there. So these 2 bits are equally split into 4 different bits. So 8 is here 8 4 bits, as well as 1 is also 4 bits. So total is 8 bits. Okay. So 8 is represented by 1000 and 1 is represented by 0001. So this is the code. This is the EBCDIC code for alphabet A. Okay, this is the EBCDIC code for alphabet A. Okay, so EBCDIC code and ASCII code. So ASCII code is, we have seen, this is the alphanumeric code. So there are 2 examples for the alphanumeric code. So first code is the ASCII code, and then after that EBCDIC code. So there are advantages and disadvantages between these 2 codes. Okay, both are alphanumeric codes which we use. One we use in the personal computers. Even nowadays also, we are using mostly this ASCII code only when compared to the EBCDIC code. Okay, next topic, if you see in the syllabus, this is the parity method, which is very, very important in the digital computer applications. Okay, parity method. Okay, parity. Parity method. What is the meaning of the parity method? You can see the definition in the slide. Okay, the number of ones in a digital word. We have seen what is a word. It is a group of bits processed at a time. Okay, so word we have seen. Okay, the number of ones in a digital word give the parity of the word. Parity means number of ones, counting of number of ones. Simple words. With simple words, I just tell you that counting of number of ones is nothing but the parity. Okay, so if you have an input, so we count the number of ones and then you put a parity bit. Okay, and then the transmitted data is going to be checked at the receiver. So the parity, when you are transmitting from the transmitter, okay, the receiver receives the transmitted data and receiver checks whether the parity, whatever the parity which is transmitted by the transmitter and the receiver parity, both are matching or not. If these two are not matching, then there is an error. It tells us that there is an error in the transmitted data. If both are matching, then there is an error. Okay, so we will see very clearly this. So parity bit is actually attached to the code group which is being transmitted from one location to another. You can see the slide very clearly that the explanation is being given. Okay, so here actually in this method an extra bit known as the parity bit is attached to the code group which is being transmitted from one location to the another. Okay, so this parity bit may be either 0 or 1. Same thing, digital a bit, or in the digital electronics we represent all the digital in the digital electronics we represent all the bits in terms of either 0 or 1. So now we will see one example here, whatever the example I have given. Okay, so application, where we use this parity method. Parity method means counting of number of ones. So we transmit the data. So just I will give one example here in order to understand what is the meaning of the parity. It is two types, even parity and odd parity. So we will see what is the parity first of all. Okay, so parity, I'm just taking 41, ASCII code 41. This is the ASCII code. Okay, so 41 is represented as 100 and then 0001. Okay, we have just seen alphabet A is represented as 41 in the ASCII code. Okay, so same example we are taking here. So this is a 7 bit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 bits we are using here, 7 bit ASCII code. Okay, so now if I assume here odd parity, I am assuming odd parity. There are two types of parities, odd parity and even parity, that we will discuss now. I am just giving one example for getting the clear picture what is the meaning of the parity. Now what happens here? Now there are how many number of ones here? 1 and then 2. There are 2 number of ones. If I assume odd parity, okay, if the number of ones are odd, there are odd parity as well as even parity. Okay, so in the odd parity, if the number of ones are odd, if the number of ones are odd, then we take the parity as 0 here if it is true. If the number of ones are, if the one number of ones are even, then it is called as 1. Okay, and here when the number of ones are even, so this is actually I call it as when it is odd, when the number of ones are odd, then it is taken as 0, and when the number of ones are even, then we consider it as a 1. In the same way here, when the number of ones are even is considered as 0, when the number of ones are odd, okay, it's considered as 1. Okay, clear? Parity is nothing but, okay, counting of the number of ones. After counting the number of ones, we are going to attach that parity bit with the transmitted data. What is the transmitted data? I am just taking the transmitted data as, okay, I am just taking the transmitted data as 1 0 0 0 0 0 1. This is the alphabet A. We have seen already ASCII code. A is represented as 41. That is nothing but 100 and then 001. Okay, this is the transmitted data. I am counting the number of ones here. When I count the number of ones here, you start from this side. There are only 2 ones here. So when I am taking odd parity, when I am considering odd parity, or when I am assuming the odd parity means, so what is odd parity here? 2 ones are there. When I am assuming the odd parity here, so 2 ones is a even number. So this is going to be 1. So that 1 we are going to attach here. So this is the parity bit. So this 1 is the parity bit which we are attaching with the transmitted data. So be clear with the concept here. Parity is counting the number of ones. We counted the number of ones here and I am assuming the odd parity. When I am assuming the odd parity, the number is an even number. So that is nothing but 1 here. So then 1 is being added with the transmitted data. Parity actually we are increasing one number for error detection. Actually it is mainly used for parity method is mainly used for the error detection. Now what happens is this is the complete transmitted data. This is the transmitted data here. This is the transmitted data including the parity bit. This complete parity bit, so you can take transmitted data with the parity bit. So how many bits are there? 8 bits are there. 8 bits is equivalent to 1 byte. So that is the reason ASCII code is very very useful in the communication. Why? Because 7 codes is a 7 bit code. When you are adding the parity bit also, it is becoming as 8 bits. So that is equivalent to 1 byte. So 1 byte, you can have a many number of bytes so that it is actually compatible with the computer. 8 bit of data, 1 byte of the data. It is nothing but 8 bits. Okay, but if you see the EBCDIC code, if you want to use the parity, you can't use over there. So parity is exactly compatible to the ASCII code where 7 bits are there. So 1 bit is reserved for, 1 bit is already vacant for the 8 bit. 7 bit is the code, okay, and 1 bit is used for the error detection. So now what happens here? This is the transmitted data we are transmitting. Okay, so now what happens here? Suppose this transmitted data I am transmitting. This is the transmitted data we are transmitting from the transmitter. Okay, this we are transmitting from the transmitter, and then same this is being received. Suppose there is an error. Okay, so now what I have taken is this 1 I have taken as 0. Okay, so how error occurs actually during the transmission, when the signal is transmitting from the transmitter to the receiver, okay, atmospheric noise is there. So that atmospheric noise corrupts the bit actually. So we transmit the data in terms of the analog signal only. These digital signals are being converted into analog signal with the help of a modem. Okay, so those analog signals we transmit in the air. So those analog signals are received and then again converted into digital with the help of modem. Modem stands for modulator, demodulator. Okay, so what I am trying to say here is when we are transmitting the signals from the transmitter to the receiver, okay, so these digital bits we are transmitting in terms of the analog signals. Okay, so this atmospheric noise, whatever the noise is there in the air, atmospheric noise corrupts the data, that is zeros and ones. So because of the corruption of the data, this 1 has become 0 here. Okay, so this is the receiver side. So receiver side again checks the parity. So parity is the parity bit we have. This is the parity bit we have. okay, again it checks whether the number of ones are even or not. But here the number of ones are what? Here it is odd. One number, this is a parity bit, and the number of ones are one here, one is nothing but an odd number. So this parity is, this is wrong. The parity is not matching here. Okay, so this is the main application where we detect the error. Okay, so you can see here, actually here this one has become zero here. So the number of ones previously at the transmitter side it was two. Now at the receiver it has become only one. So one is nothing but odd number. So odd number means you must have zero here, but it is one here. So which is wrong. You can say the receiver detects that there is an error in the transmitted data. There is an error in the transmitted data. Okay. So parity is actually used. That is only the, this is the main disadvantage here. Actually, there is a we are going to discuss again how we can't detect more than two errors actually. More than two, it has only detects a single error. That we are going to see some examples here. Very clearly we are going to discuss. So I would like to give an idea here. So there is a parity. Parity is nothing but counting of number of ones. Okay. After counting the number of ones, we attach the number of one, whether it is a depending upon the odd or even, we attach that parity bit with the transmitted data, and this transmitted data we transmit in the air. And that transmitted data along with the parity bit is received at the receiver. The receiver again checks the parity, whether the same parity is matching or not, first of all. If the parity is matching, then there is no error. If the parity is not matching, then there is an error. Okay, detects the error. But there is a problem here. It detects only single errors we are going to discuss now. But before going to that, you see the application here. Application is